Well, as we mentioned last night, it's exactly a year today before the Olympic flame lights up London. And as John Coates confidently predicted in our chat yesterday, Australia can look forward to a swag of medals. For some of our athletes, however, just getting to the Games will be pretty extraordinary in itself. Here's Leanne West with a woman who should already have a gold medal for resilience.
Sergeant Kylie Koenig likes to keep a step ahead of the crooks on her beat.
There is no intelligence for firearms at the location or on the persons.
She's on light duties at the moment, but once she's back out on the streets, she's not the type you want to mess with. She's a judo player with London in her sights.
From, I think, the age of 8 or 9, I knew what an Olympics was, and it just took me from that age.
She's now 35. That Olympic clock is ticking harder than ever. And 10 weeks ago, it looked like her time would never come.
For quite a few nights, it was like a bad dream. I'd wake up and try and move my leg and know it's real. It's happened again.
Should Kylie Koenig get to London, her story will be as much about the journey as the final destination. Had everything gone to plan, she would have competed here at the Sydney Olympics. But that's just about where this hard luck story begins. And it starts with a thief who was stealing from cars.
I tried to arrest him and he bowled me over.
Kylie's knee was gone. She became a spectator as fellow Australian Maria Peckley won a bronze medal. Motherhood clashed with the Athens Olympics. Ryan and Josh arrived before a promising return to the judo mat.
I thought, yeah, I'm back and I'm back better and this is it.
Not so. A year out from the Beijing Olympics, a knee injury at training and reconstruction surgery. She fought her way back, but the day before her final selection event, another knee injury.
I laugh about it now because there's no other way to deal with it. It's laugh or cry. I've had 5 knee operations on one knee.
She decided to have one last shot. Back onto the treadmill of full-time police work, training and overseas competition. Her husband playing Mr. Mum to their boys. And that brings us back to 10 weeks ago. Another knee injury.
Devastation, because you've put so much into it, and it's not just me. There's a whole team involved in this process, and you know, firstly it's my husband. He's given up so much to help me try and achieve my dream. You know, I've missed my kids' birthdays being overseas competing and being on to them on Skype and crying.
But that's where this story takes a turn for the better. Kylie had Lars surgery, a knee reconstruction using a synthetic ligament. Instead of a 9-month recovery, she was back in light training 11 days after surgery.
It's just an amazing story of dedication. I've never coached anyone with the same amount of drive as she has. And she just keeps bouncing back all the time.
The dream is still alive, and there's a very special added incentive. Husband Wally Koenig went to the Seoul Olympics as a wrestler.
It'd be great to be able to say to the kids one day that both mum and dad are Olympians, you know, and it is a big thing, so it means a lot. It means everything to us.
A part of me kind of just says enjoy the ride because it won't happen. I don't want to set myself up for such another fall again, but the other part of me, it's trying 110%.
Ryan and Josh are making sure of that.
Good on her.